Hey everyone, Brendan here, just with another quick video. Just wanted to check out the newest update from Bricks, 1.9.4. I also see that they have redone their website, so that looks good. I'm going to go to the bottom to go to the changelog. Alright, so the highlights are maintenance mode, which has added unlimited remote template URLs. That's been a long requested feature, which I think is really great for the community at large. I think it's going to be people are going to buy more remote templates. People are going to use them. People are going to maybe make their own remote templates and use those on their own sites, on their client sites. It's going to be a really nice feature to have to be able to pull in from other sites. So we're going to check that out. I haven't installed it yet, so I just wanted to look at it. There's a bunch of other changes. You can see the full changelog. Anyway, let's get into it. Let's close that. Let's go here. We've got 1.9.4 installed, so we can see here we've got a new maintenance mode tab. And there's maintenance and coming soon, which depending on your needs, you're going to want to choose and understand that you understand those status codes. You choose which template to use for the maintenance mode or coming soon. And that's kind of nice. You have some permissions here if you need to set your client's edit access, things like that. So that is all well and good. Let's go to templates, my templates here. So I've already got frames installed. I know that's probably one of the more popular libraries though. I want to be able to add other ones though. So let me pull in, I'm going to pull in Bricks Maven, which I bought the ACSS version of it. And I'm going to paste in the password. Let's add also, I've got pulled up here, Fancy Bricks. So we can try that out. And I think we just save that, and that should work. I don't see an option to delete. Maybe you just remove it and resave. Okay, great. So let's go here. Let's trash that test one. Let's pull this other one. Let's just call it test, publish. All right, and then let's edit with Bricks, and let's see what kind of options we've gotten here. So we've got, let's go to our templates up here, templates. And this looks a little bit different. There's now a drop down. So that is pulling in all the templates. That's great. So just be careful when you mix and match templates. You know, there's going to be, especially if there's classes that come in, just make sure to stay organized. There's an error. And I'm on a test install, so on local, so I don't know if that has anything to do with it. Frames licensing server. Okay, well, let's load this one. All right, so the Bricks Maven loaded right in, and I probably just need to resave the frames password. So let's just, I don't know, add some kind of hero section. Okay, well, our color's a little messed up. That's all right. That's not their fault. Let's go again to here. I want to pull in a grid and just see what Advanced Themer's new visual grid builder does with it. So if I type in grid, and let's choose something like that. Okay, so got our grid 24, and okay, there's a grid there. Let's just, I don't know, do something like that, and that will instantly change it. So that's awesome, and that's just at the ID level. So, you know, make sure you're styling classes. I don't think there's query loops available for the grid builder yet, but I believe Maxime is already working on that. So that'll be awesome. So that works with a template that's already pulled in. Let's just add Cwicly another grid and see what we are working with. Let's just call this test grid item. And I don't know, let's just put in some stuff. Okay, button, let's get a different button on there. Let's just go white button. Okay, so let's put a little gap in here. Now, I don't think this is gonna work. I don't know how container queries are gonna work with this. I saw some discussion on Facebook about it, but I'll kind of wait till this is fully released before we look at it more in depth. Okay, so great. So let's just get some basic styling in here so we can see it. Okay. Great. So now if I duplicate this block a few times, let's get, I don't know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's go 9. All right. So awesome. Then we go to the container here to see the grid builder and make sure to change this to grid, and this icon will appear. That's awesome. And okay. Columns 4. Can we do 5 here? Can we do 6? Okay. Let's do that. And I'm having some kind of bug right now on local. I just tried this earlier and I can't swap any of these. I can, however, make them bigger. So let's do that. Let's do that one like that. And whatever, there's some overlap. I don't know, let's do that. Okay, so that works. That has created my grid. Not the most beautiful grid, but functional. And that'll apply it all the way across, yeah. So that is working as intended. That's awesome. Okay, well, check those out. There's gonna be more remote templates available probably from other people. And now you can try out other ones. There's a lot of free ones that you can check out. I don't know what the website is, but I'll try and find it and put it in the description. It's like bricksdirectory or something.com. Anyway, check it out. Remote templates, Visual Grid Builder, if you've got Advanced Themer. If you don't have it, you should probably get it. And anyway, all right, see you guys, bye.